MRN is in Richmond, Virginia to bring you another exciting NASCAR Winston Cup race from the Richmond International Raceway. Barney, the fans are eager for the race to begin. Tell us about Richmond.
Richmond is a great racetrack. It's always fun to come here. We should see some close racing, so anything can happen here.
Tony Stewart comes to the track with the hopes of maintaining his top 5 points position.
Oh yeah, and all these guys in the top five are fighting hard week in and week out to gain as many points as possible. It's harder to pick up spots once you're into the top five.
In 1992, Kyle Petty enjoyed one of his finest seasons in Winston Cup with a fifth-place points finish, 2 wins, and 5 front-row starting spots.
And he followed that up with another fifth-place points finish the next year. But after that, he struggled for a long, long while, reaching a career low of 43rd place after the 2001 season.
Jimmy Johnson will try for another top five finish in this one.
And let me tell you something, Joe. You throw in a couple of wins to go along with those top fives, and all of a sudden, you're in the hunt for the championship.
Take it easy. inside. Hold your line. You're still there. Still there. Still beside you.
Might be time for a new left rear tire.
Okay, we're clear.
You gotta take better care of that car, man.
And head out for a long track. The field breaks back to the start infinity line, but we are under caution. The yellow flag is out after a problem out on the race course. That's a tough break for those guys.
Clear all around. A lot of cars stayed out on that caution, so we're starting toward the back. You gained a lot of position that fast.
NASCAR says that's halfway.
Number 45 is looking to pass. Clear. The 4 car is outside.
3.5 seconds behind the leader.
Just made the top 20. Okay, we're clear. Got one eye. All clear, buddy. The 16 car up high. The 32 car isn't going to let you by easily. Number 16 is still there. You put another behind you. You're clear. Clock high.
I'm clocking the leader in about 2 seconds ahead.
Number 32 is attempting a block. All clear, buddy. Far outside.
Some of the leaders are coming in together.
Number 23 is looking right.
Don't let him by, but try not to hold him up either.
Clear.
That damage will slow you down a little. Be patient. Your right front tire's wearing down. Try another line or it won't last. Just 5 to go. Tire's a little worn. Fuel tank ought to be about half empty.
Number 1 is exiting pit row ahead. 3 wide!
If he catches you, he might try to wreck you.
Okay, we're clear. Clear all around. Coming up on cars exiting pit road. Number 16 made some contact. We're okay. Got one down low. Okay, we're clear.
2 more times around.
The 16 car up high. Number 16 has got a run on you. You're clear.
Take a look at the fuel gauge.
The over with. Wear first. That's the way to do it.
Lead changes were pretty scarce.
Yeah, there weren't too many battles up front for position. Those guys who ran in the top five were pretty dominant all race long.
Jimmy Johnson had a very solid lead coming to the checkered flag.
He worked hard to build that cushion on his lead. Pays off when you cross the finish line all by yourself.
The 48 car will probably be exchanging words in the garage with the 40 car.
That certainly looks that way. I'm not sure who started everything, but it should be fun to watch over the next couple of races to see what develops.